Hey, it's Missy, welcome back. For today's video, I thought it would be fun to share three fall fishtail braids since it's now the fall, which is my favorite season ever. So I hope you enjoy this video. If you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe it down below and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm starting with a part slightly off center, and I'm just going to pick up a small section of hair on the left side of my part and divide it into two halves for the fishtail braid. So for the fishtail braid, I'm going to take a small section from the right side, cross it under and add it into the left side. Then I'm taking a small piece from the left side, crossing it under and adding it into the right side. Now I'm going to cross a small section under, but also pick up a new section of hair and cross both underneath, adding them into the left side. Then I'm going to do the same thing with the left side, crossing a small section under, picking up a new section of hair and adding both into the right side. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing the Dutch fishtail braid, until I've added four new sections into the braid. Then I'm just going to continue the fishtail braid down to the ends. And then I'm going to go back over the braid and gently pull on the edges to make it a little bit wider and more full. And then so it doesn't unravel, I'm going to crisscross two bobby pins over the bottom. And now I'm just going to repeat those same steps and create a second fishtail braid on the other side of my head. Once both braids are done, I'm just going to bring them together at the back of my head and tie them off with a clear elastic band. This is a really simple way to keep the braids from coming loose and they'll stay put all day long. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to start by creating a part on the right side. Then I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the heavy side of the part and split this into two halves for the braid. I'm going to take a small piece of hair from the right half and cross it underneath, adding it into the left half. Then I'm going to take a small piece from the left half, cross it under and add it into the right half. And now I'm going to take a small piece from the right, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under as well, adding it into the left side. Then I'm crossing a small piece from the left side under to the right, picking up a new section of hair and adding it into the right side as well. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, continuing the Dutch fishtail braid until it reaches my left ear. Once the braid reaches my ear, I want to curve the braid around the back of my head, so I'm going to switch my hands and continue the braid, adding in hair from both the top of my head and the nape of my neck. As the braid gets closer to my right ear, I want to make sure I've added all of my hair into the braid. This makes it easier to avoid getting those little bumps on the right side of the head. So once all of my hair is brought in, then I'm just going to braid down to the ends and crisscross two bobby pins over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Then I'm just going to go back over the braid and pull on the edges to make it a little bit bigger, and then I'm going to lay it across the top of my head and pin it in place with bobby pins. So for the third hairstyle, I'm going to start by combining all of my hair together at the back of my head and tie it off with a hairband. And then to hide the hairband, I'm going to wrap a small section of hair around it and secure the end with two bobby pins. And then I'm just going to divide my ponytail into two halves and begin a fishtail braid. So I'm taking a small section from the outside edge of the left half and crossing it over to the right half. Then I'm crossing a small section from the right half over to the left half, and I'm just going to repeat those steps, crossing small sections from one side over to the opposite side until I'm about 3/4 of the way down the hair. Then I'm going to go back over the braid and pull on the edges to make it wider and more full. And the more you pull on the braid, the more casual it'll look, so I made it a lot bigger than usual. And then I'm just going to take a small section of hair and wrap it around the bottom of the braid. And then I'm going to take a clear elastic band, wrap it over the end of the braid, making sure to include the end from the little wrapped piece. And this will tie off the braid while simultaneously hiding the elastic band. So that wraps up today's video. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, make sure to click the thumbs up and let me know down below in the comment section which hairstyle you liked the best. I love to know which hairstyle was the favorite, so be sure to let me know down below in the comments. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.